Blackstone. The name Blackstone has been synonymous with the art of magic for 100 years. The legendary first family of magic has toured throughout the United States in what Newsweek magazine called the largest and most spectacular traveling magic show ever. When Harry Blackstone steps on stage, he brings with him the precious legacy of an American theatrical giant, his father, the great Blackstone.
My father was a rather dynamic performer, but off stage, he was the most gentle, generous man that you could possibly want to know. When I was about 6 months old, my mom and dad were working at a small theater in Chicago called the Oriental Theater. And the business was so good that they had to add an extra show that day, and they forgot to tell the babysitter, and little Harry Jr. was left in the dressing room, and mother said, I can't leave him in there. I'll take him into the illusion with me, and I'll go do the show. So mother said that she took me into this illusion, where she usually appeared as the Statue of Liberty with a torch and a book, and the squalling infant that she had with her at that time, making a lot of racket. Father said, well, I guess we might as well go ahead and do it, and came the time for mother to appear, and her hand came out with a baby bottle instead of the torch, and in her arm was this squalling infant instead of the book, and father went over, picked me up in his arms, took me down, and introduced me to the audience, who began laughing and applauding, and he said that I looked at that audience and started to smile, and he knew right then I was going to be in show business. When he advised me not to be in magic, not to be in show business, later on when I began working in that area, I said, Dad, why did you try so hard to talk me out of it? And he said, Harry Jr., I didn't try very hard at all, and I figured if the little bit of discouragement I gave you was enough to discourage you, then you'd never want to do it enough to be a success. He said, every kid from 6 to 16 wants to learn about magic, and those who never mature become professionals.
Harry Blackstone's destiny became clear when he took to the road with his own illusion show. Far from being satisfied with just resurrecting his father's act, Harry brought his own unique and modern approach to his presentations, the likes of which even the great Blackstone would have marveled at. His popularity is the proof of his success. No magician in history has been more honored by his peers than Harry Blackstone. Named Magician of the Year in both 1979 and 1985. The Society of American Magicians International Ambassador of Magic and recipient of the coveted Star of Magic, an honor bestowed to only 11 other magicians, including his father. After setting box office records across the United States, he arrived at the Majestic Theater on Broadway, where he presented one of the longest running illusion shows in the history of New York theater.
The highlight for me was working in England the first time. And we were at the Opera House in Blackpool, England. We had 6,000 people in the audience, mostly magicians who had heard about this young American magician to come over and do his magic. And they all sat there rather skeptically. And at the end of the first part, I received polite applause. And then we did our pièce de résistance, that of the floating light bulb, where a light bulb is taken out of the lamp, placed in midair, still lit, and floats without any means of connection or any kind of support. And then it floats out over the heads of the audience and across the audience and back to me on stage. Well, following that moment of my performance, the rather, shall we say, discreet British audience gave us the honor of a 5-minute standing ovation. And I think that was the greatest moment that I can ever recall standing on stage.
Always challenging his career to higher levels, Harry then set his sights on television. He has starred in several television specials nationally and internationally, and also portrayed a multitude of characters during guest starring appearances on numerous popular television shows. In 1991, Harry had the pleasure of hosting the International Magic Awards, a television spectacular seen by millions of people worldwide. Although normally in the spotlight himself, Harry has built yet another reputation for making other stars shine. As the creator of special effects and illusions for such superstar concert tours as Earth, Wind & Fire and New Kids on the Block.
was a big 8-foot square version of their album cover, and they stepped inside of the album cover, which then floated out over the audience, caught on fire, exploded, came apart, and they were gone.
Harry is fortunate to share his stage and his life with co-producer Gay Blackstone.
Gay and I have been working together since our first production show, and that was at Harris Club in 1970. She was a dancer and choreographer for the show. In fact, the reason we married was when we went to negotiate for her work as choreographer, I found it was cheaper to marry her than it was to pay her. But she's always been the one to support, to encourage, to, if you will, give me the impetus and the momentum to move into new areas. If I'm able to get an audience to willingly suspend its disbelief, then my philosophy is that they have accepted the fantasy that I'm trying to present as reality. If they can take home a sense of enjoyment, a sense of fun, a sense of fantasy, then I feel that I've done as much as I can do. Because you see, I don't do the magic. The magic is done in the eye and the mind of the beholder. I'm just the storyteller, I'm the conduit through which the magic happens. But you as the audience are the one that makes the magic happen.
Blackstone. The name Blackstone has been synonymous with the art of magic for 100 years. The legendary first family of magic has toured throughout the United States in what Newsweek magazine called the largest and most spectacular traveling magic show ever. When Harry Blackstone steps on stage, he brings with him the precious legacy of an American theatrical giant, his father, the great Blackstone.
My father was a rather dynamic performer, but offstage, he was the most gentle, generous man that you could possibly want to know. When I was about 6 months old, my mom and dad were working at a small theater in Chicago called the Oriental Theater. And the business was so good that they had to add an extra show that day, and they forgot to tell the babysitter, and little Harry Jr. was left in the dressing room, and mother said, I can't leave him in there. I'll take him into the illusion with me, and I'll go do the show. So mother said that she took me into this illusion, where she usually appeared as the Statue of Liberty with a torch and a book, and the squalling infant that she had with her at that time, making a lot of racket. Father said, well, I guess we might as well go ahead and do it. And came the time for mother to appear, and her hand came out with a baby bottle instead of the torch. And in her arm was this squalling infant instead of the book. And father went over, picked me up in his arms, took me down and introduced me to the audience, who began laughing and applauding. And he said that I looked at that audience and started to smile. And he knew right then I was going to be in show business. When he advised me not to be in magic, not to be in show business, later on when I began working in that area, I said, Dad, why did you try so hard to talk me out of it? And he said, Harry Jr., I didn't try very hard at all, and I figured if the little bit of discouragement I give you was enough to discourage you, then you'd never want to do it enough to be a success. He said, every kid from 6 to 16 wants to learn about magic, and those who never mature become professionals.
Harry Blackstone's destiny became clear when he took to the road with his own illusion show. Far from being satisfied with just resurrecting his father's act, Harry brought his own unique and modern approach to his presentations, the likes of which even the great Blackstone would have marveled at. His popularity is the proof of his success. No magician in history has been more honored by his peers than Harry Blackstone. Named Magician of the Year in both 1979 and 1985. The Society of American Magicians International Ambassador of Magic and recipient of the coveted Star of Magic, an honor bestowed to only 11 other magicians, including his father. After setting box office records across the United States, he arrived at the Majestic Theater on Broadway, where he presented one of the longest-running illusion shows in the history of New York theater.
The highlight for me was working in England the first time. And we were at the Opera House in Blackpool, England. We had 6,000 people in the audience, mostly magicians who had heard about this young American magician to come over and do his magic. And they all sat there rather skeptically. And at the end of the first part, I received polite applause. And then we did our pièce de résistance, that of the floating light bulb, where a light bulb is taken out of the lamp, placed in midair, still lit, and floats without any means of connection or any kind of support. And then it floats out over the heads of the audience and across the audience and back to me on stage. Well, following that moment of my performance, the rather, shall we say, discreet British audience gave us the honor of a 5-minute standing ovation. And I think that was the greatest moment that I can ever recall standing on stage.
Always challenging his career to higher levels, Harry then set his sights on television. He has starred in several television specials nationally and internationally, and also portrayed a multitude of characters during guest starring appearances on numerous popular television shows. In 1991, Harry had the pleasure of hosting the International Magic Awards, a television spectacular seen by millions of people worldwide. Although normally in the spotlight himself, Harry has built yet another reputation for making other stars shine. As the creator of special effects and illusions for such superstar concert tours as Earth, Wind & Fire and New Kids on the Block.
It was a big 8-foot square version of their album cover, and they stepped inside of the album cover, which then floated out over the audience, caught on fire, exploded, came apart, and they were gone.
Harry is fortunate to share his stage and his life with co-producer Gay Blackstone.
Gay and I have been working together since our first production show, and that was at Harrah's Club in 1970. She was a dancer and choreographer for the show. In fact, the reason we married was when we went to negotiate for her work as choreographer, I found it was cheaper to marry her than it was to pay her. But she's always been the one to support, to encourage, to, if you will, give me the impetus and the momentum to move into new areas. If I'm able to get an audience to willingly suspend its disbelief, then my philosophy is that they have accepted the fantasy that I'm trying to present as reality. If they can take home a sense of enjoyment, a sense of fun, a sense of fantasy, then I feel that I've done as much as I can do. Because you see, I don't do the magic. The magic is done in the eye and the mind of the beholder. I'm just the storyteller, I'm the conduit through which the magic happens. But you, as the audience, are the one that makes the magic happen.